cheap cross section. This is the tool. The tool is advancing in this direction along the longitudinal speed. This is S. This is S. You just draw this figure. Okay. This is the depth of cut. Now, this figure, this is the first position of the tool, and tool advances with S per revolution, S millimeter. So this point is this. You drop a perpendicular on this, and then this is drop a perpendicular on this. This is T. Okay, this is B. This is A. This is phi. Okay, then this figure, this figure is drawn here. Okay. SCB 90 degree, ESC 90 degree, ADC 90 degree. Now, from this figure, we can easily AB is equal to feed, that is S. AC is equal to A. This is uncut chip thickness. This A. This one. AD is equal to T is equal to depth of cut. AE is equal to B is width of cut, width of the chip. B is assumed to be constant before and after cutting. Phi is equal to main or principal cutting angle. Now, sine phi is equal to A by S. Sine phi is equal to A by S. And sine phi is equal to sine phi is equal to T by B. T by B. So from here, A is equal to S sine phi. One equation, B is equal to T by sine phi. If you multiply this A into B, then sine phi cancel out, S into T will come. So AB is equal to ST. What is AB? Is equal to chip cross section area A. So A is equal to AB is equal to ST. This is the three number three equation. Now here is a small problem. Feed rate is given, S is equal to 0.2 millimeter per revolution, phi is equal to 60 degree, T is equal to 2 mm. Find AB. Now solution, A is equal to S sine phi, so it is, this is the A millimeter per revolution. A B is equal to S T is equal to A. A will be equal to A into B. 0.4 millimeter square per revolution. This is the answer of A. B is equal to this. Okay, millimeter per revolution. This is the answer. So this is a just a okay. Now then come to this figure. This is the mechanics of chip formation in orthogonal cutting. Okay. Draw this figure. Okay, this is PN is equal to A2, this PN is equal to A1, this is beta, this is gamma, this is the, along this is VS and along this VF. Now you see, this is the triangles figure A. Now the nomenclature A1 is equal to uncut chip thickness. A2 is equal to cut chip thickness. Now OP is the shear plane. From figure 1A, we have sine beta is equal to A1 by OP, or A1 is equal to OP sin beta. This is number one. Again, cos beta minus gamma is equal to A2 by OP. This is beta minus gamma. So cos beta minus gamma is equal to cos A2 cos beta minus gamma is equal to OP. This is right angles, so cos beta minus gamma is equal to this A2 by OP. So A2 will be equal to OP cos beta minus gamma, 1 into OP can be eliminated, A1 by A2 is called R. Is equal to sin beta by cos beta minus gamma. Is equal to sin beta cos A cos B plus sin A sin B. So A1 by A2 will be equal to 1 by cot beta cos gamma plus sin beta gamma is equal to R. Thus 1 is equal to R cos beta cos gamma plus R sin gamma. Okay. So from here, 1 minus R sin gamma divided by 1 minus R sin gamma divided by cot beta cos gamma means R cos gamma is equal to cot beta. So from here, cot beta is found out. So tan beta will be equal to R cos gamma divided by 1 minus R sin gamma. This is equation number A. This equation, very useful equation. Now draw this figure. This is A1 uncut chip thickness, A2 cut chip thickness, B2 is the width of the cut chip thickness with width of this uncut. This A1 is equal to A1 B1 and A2 is equal to A2 B2. Okay. This is the tool. A2 is equal to cut strip cross section is equal to A2 B2. A1 is equal to uncut strip cross section is equal to A1 B1. These are the assumptions, important assumptions for calculation. Number one, volume of metal before and after cutting remains the same. Number two, width of cut remains the same before and after cutting. Both the B's are same. B1 is equal to B2. Now, according to first assumption, L1 A1 B1 is equal to L2 A2 B2, where L1 is equal to uncut length, L2 is equal to cut length. L refers to length. According to this is the volume, okay? These volumes are equal before and after cutting. According to second assumption, B1 is equal to B2. So this cancels. So L1 A1 is equal to L2 A2. So A1 by A2 will be equal to L2 by L1, that is equal to R, is equal to sin beta by cos beta minus gamma, which we have found earlier. Here R is equal to chip thickness coefficient. Chip thickness coefficient is equal to A1 by A2. Oh, 1 by R, this is 1 by R, is equal to chip reduction coefficient. is equal to a2 by a1. This opposite, this just 1 by of this is equal to this chinno. Jai. Velocity relationship. Now this is Vs, this is beta, this is Vc, and this is Vf. So this plus this is equal to this. You see, Vf by sine beta from the triangle, from properties of triangle. Vf by sine beta is equal to Vs by sine 90 degree minus gamma is equal to Vc by sine 90 degree minus beta minus gamma. Okay. So from here Vf will be equal to Vc into sine beta by cos beta minus gamma. Vc into R. So Vs is equal to Vc into cos gamma by cos beta minus gamma. Okay. Now mechanics of orthogonal metal cutting. Number one, the relationship, the relationships amongst the various forces have been worked out by merchants with a large number of assumptions. Number one, the cutting edge of the tool is perfectly sharp and it does not make any flank contact. With the workpiece. Number two, only continuous chip without built up edge is produced. Number three, chip width does not change, that is the chip does not flow to either side. Number four, feed rate and depth of cut are constant. Number five, relative cutting speed is uniform throughout. Six, the chip behaves as a free body in stable equilibrium. Seventh, the inertia force of the chip is entirely neglected. Okay, so after that we will come to the course analysis.